good. Let's get that done. Let's get that filled in, or else you're going to end up with a line.
This is painting on silk.
Painting on silk.
Painting on silk. It's not, we're not making scarves necessarily. We're making paintings. They can be framed, you know, hung on the wall. They can be used for cushions, that kind of thing. They're a wonderful art form because they're also useful. Mm-hmm. And so, and portable, and, you know, they cover a lot of wall. If you're a kind of a person who is very bold and brave, as one of my students here, it's a wonderful medium for just freedom. It gives you a lot of freedom. The trouble is that within that freedom, you have to, if you want a line, say, or something like that, you have to plan it ahead of time. Which is why we do a drawing first with a special material that's called guta. We use that to contain the paint. Some of my painters are using a clear guta, which means that these painters can paint over top of their painting, and then after it dries, they remove the guta, and it's like batik.
Yeah.
Yeah. So there's different kinds of techniques, depending on what kind of result you want.
What you can do at this stage is you can go in and you can smooth that out a little bit.
This particular art form, 10 years. I learned it up in, I learned it from Wendy Lee up in the Inuvik Art Festival, the Great Northern Art Festival.
Oh, yeah.
Yes, I took one of her workshops and it was so exciting. And the potential to me was just obvious. I had worked in watercolor and acrylics for years and years and years, and, you know, to transport a watercolor painting, even to show a watercolor painting, you have to frame it behind glass, you know. Mm-hmm. None of that preparation is necessary with this wonderful medium.
Yeah.